Good evening, I'm Everett Thomas, Rector at St. Francis by the Sea, and I do want to welcome you to this place. I always feel that this church is really a diocesan church. It is a church that we all, in a sense, own because of where it is, and because of all the guests that we have here. And so those of us who are here all the time are caretakers, and we welcome you to this, your own church, and we're so glad to have you here. Grace be unto you, and peace from God our Father, and from the Lord Jesus Christ. O worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth stand in awe of him.
Oh, Lord, make haste. A reading from Hebrews. Since we have confidence to enter the sanctuary by the blood of Jesus, by the new and living way that he opened for us through the curtain, that is, through his flesh, and since we have a great priest over the house of God, let us approach with a true heart in full assurance of faith, with our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast to the confession that our hope without wavering, for he who has promised is faithful. And let us consider how to provoke one another to love and good deeds, not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. For if we willingly persist in sin after having received the knowledge of the truth, there no longer remains a sacrifice for sins, but a fearful prospect of judgment and a fury of fire that will consume the adversaries. Anyone who has violated the law of Moses dies without mercy on the testimony of two or three witnesses. How much worse punishment do you think will be deserved by those who have spurned the Son of God, profaned the blood of the covenant by which they were sanctified, and outrage the spirit of grace? For we know the one who said, "Vengeance is mine, I will repay." And again, the Lord will judge his people. It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of a living God. Here ends the reading.
My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior.
A reading from John. Now in Jerusalem by the sheep gate, there is a pool, called in Hebrew Bethesda, which has five porticos. In these lay many invalids, blind, lame, and paralyzed. One man was there who had been ill for 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there and knew he had been there for a long time, he said to him, "Do you want to be made well?" The sick man answered him, "Sir, I have no one to put me in the pool when the water is stirred up. And while I am making my way, someone else steps down ahead of me." Jesus said to him, "Stand up, take your mat and walk." At once the man was made well, and he took up his mat and began to walk. Now that day was a Sabbath. So the Jews said to the man who had been cured, "It is the Sabbath. It is not lawful for you to carry your mat." But when he answered them, "The man who made me well said to me, 'Take up your mat and walk.'" And they asked who it was, for Jesus had disappeared into the crowd that was there. Later Jesus found him in the temple and said to him, "See, you have been made well. Do not sin any more so that nothing worse happens to you." The man went away and told the Jews that it was Jesus who had made him well. Therefore, the Jews started persecuting Jesus because he was doing such things on the Sabbath. But Jesus answered them, "My Father is still working, and I also am working." For this reason, the Jews were seeking all the more to kill him, because he was not only breaking the Sabbath, but was also calling God his own Father, thereby making himself equal to God. Herein ends the reading.
I believe in God, the Father,
Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried, he descended into hell.
Thank you. Oh, the general thanksgiving. Almighty God,
Father of all mercies, we are unworthy servants to give you most humble and hearty thanks for all thy goodness and loving kindness to us and to all men. We bless thee for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for thy goodness and love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and the hope of glory. And we beseech thee, give us that due sense of all thy mercies, that our hearts may be unfeignedly thankful, and that we show forth thy praise,
not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to thy service, and by walking before thee in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Spirit
be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore. Amen.
Thank you. Okay.